Hello there, Matt with LINBIT here. In the following video, I will demonstrate a smooth failover of an HA NFS cluster using DRBD and Pacemaker in the Microsoft Azure cloud. What I mean by smooth failover is that I will fail over to a peer node while a client is actively writing to the NFS share. And besides a moment of degraded write speed, the client won't notice the failover at all, so no I/O errors or any need to rewrite the data from the user's perspective. An interesting bit about clustering in Azure that you'll notice in this video is the absence of a virtual IP address in our cluster resources. Moving a virtual IP address between peers is typically the method used to redirect client traffic to an active node in an active passive HA cluster. However, in cloud environments, moving and exposing a secondary IP address can be cumbersome or simply impossible. In Azure, we're able to use a load balancer instead of a virtual IP to intelligently direct client traffic to our active node. Optionally, and as I've done in this cluster, an Azure LB resource can be defined in Pacemaker to respond to health probes from a load balancer. So this helps with smooth failover and also allows you to redirect client traffic to UDP-based services, as well as plenty of other more niche use cases. Anyway, let's get on to the demo. So we've got two VMs in a resource group along with our load balancer. This resource group is the Pacemaker HA Cluster 0 resource group. And I'll show you the load balancer here existing in that same group. And on the load balancer, we've configured our backend pool to point to our two cluster nodes in our resource group. And we have our health probe set to monitor TCP port 61000, which is the Azure LB resource I mentioned I would show you in this demo. And that's defined in our pacemaker configuration on our nodes. And then of course, a bunch of rules forwarding traffic through our load balancer to our NFS resource group. And I am shelled into our two cluster nodes, as well as my laptop, which I've mounted the device from. But in our pacemaker cluster, we see we have our DRBD device, and we're currently active on node A. And we have our file system mounted on node A that is going to be shared out via our NFS server, this export resource. And then finally, I have our Azure LB resource running, which is responding to those health probes on port 61000. And I'm also shelled into my laptop, which I've mounted the device on. And I can show you a quick write to see what performance we should be getting. And my upload speed here is 20 megabits per second. And that's about what we're seeing there in the 2.4 megabytes per second write speed. So to demonstrate, I'll begin writing a large file and then kill the primary node before the write completes. And what we should see is that there are no I/O errors caused by the failover and that the write eventually completes successfully. So let me queue up that command to reset our box. And we'll begin our write and reset our active node. Flip over to B, we see that B will quickly take over services. Everything's now running on node B. And we'll watch our write complete over here. And finally, we see our write has completed, albeit quite a bit slower for our write occurring during our failover, but that's better than an unavailable NFS mount. And after we failed over, we can see that everything's chugging along like normal on the secondary node. For more information on HA clustering with Pacemaker and DRBD in Azure, head over to LINBIT.com and check out the tech guide section, or better yet, reach out to LINBIT directly. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.